Welcome to a lesson on how to write base 10 numbers in different bases. A base system is a structure within which we count. The easiest way to describe a base system is to think about our own base 10 system. The base 10 system, which we call the decimal system, requires a total of 10 different symbols or digits to write any number. They are, of course, 0 through 9 listed here. The decimal system is also an example of a positional base system, which simply means that the position of a digit gives its place value. Not all civilizations had a positional system, even though they did have a base with which they worked. In our base 10 system, a number like 5,783,216 has meaning to us because we are familiar with the system and its places. We can take this number and assign each of its digits a value. One way to do this is given in the table. Notice how the 5 represents 5 one millions, which we can also write as 5 times 10 to the 6th. The 7 represents 7 one hundred thousands, which we can also write as 7 times 10 to the 5th, and so on. Notice how to determine the value of each position or place value. We could take our base 10, starting with 10 to the 0, which would give us 1, and then increase the exponent by 1, to determine place values. 10 to the first gives us the tens place value, 10 to the second gives us the hundreds, 10 to the third gives us the thousands, and so on. However, base 10 is not the only option we have. Practically any positive integer greater than or equal to 2 can be used as a base for a number system. Such systems can work just like the decimal system, except the number of symbols will be different, and each position will depend on the base itself. For example, let's suppose we adopt a base 5 system. The only modern digits we would need for this system are 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So to determine the place values in such a system, we would take the base 5, start with 5 to the 0, which would give us the 1's place value, and then start increasing the exponent by 1. 5 to the 1st would give us the 5's place value, 5 to the 2nd would give us the 25's place value, 5 to the 3rd would give us the 125's place value, and so on. So by knowing the base, we can determine the value of each place value. As an example, 4,322 we know in base 10, which we could indicate with a small 10 here. The 4 means 4 1,000s, the 3 means 3 100s, the 2 here means 2 10s, and this 2 means 2 1s. But if we change this to base 5, now the 4 represents 4 5 to the thirds, or 4 125s. The 3 indicates 3 5 to the seconds, or 25s. This 2 here means 2 5 to the firsts, or 2 fives, and this 2 means 2 ones. So if we wanted to determine the value of this number in base 10, we could do so by multiplying the digit by its place value, as we see here. So if we simplify on the right, notice how we get 587 in base 10. So we can say that 4322 in base 5 is equal to 587 in base 10. But in this lesson, we'll focus on how to convert a number in base 10 to a different base. And we're going to use what's called the remainder method. In another video, we'll take a look at how we can use decimals to do these conversions using a calculator. So for the remainder method to convert base 10 to base B, number 1 will find the highest power of the base that will divide into the given number at least once and then divide. Step 2 will write down the whole number part, then use a remainder from the division in the next step. Step 3 will repeat step 2, dividing by the next highest power of the base B, writing down the whole number part, including 0, and using the remainder in the next step. Step 4, continue until the remainder is smaller than the base. This last remainder will be the ones place. Step 5, collect all your whole number parts to get the number in base B notation. So let's take a look at two examples. We want to convert the base 10 number 83 to base 2. To begin, I like to write out the place values in base 2. So we'll start with 2 to the 0 power, which is equal to 1, and then we'll increase the exponent by 1 to find several more place values. So 2 to the first gives us 2, 2 to the second 4, 2 to the third 8, 2 to the fourth 16, and so on. This indicates the place values for base 2. And now we're looking for the highest power of 2 that will divide into the given number 83 at least once. Notice how that would be 2 to the 6th or 64, because 2 to the 7th would be too large. So because we know that 2 to the 6th is the highest power of 2 that divides at least once into 83, we know our number in base 2 is going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 digits. So let's go ahead and leave room for all 7 digits. And now we'll start dividing. We'll divide 83 by 64. 64 divides once into 83. 1 times 64 is 64. Notice here we have a remainder of 19. The whole number part of our quotient, in this case 1, gives us the digit in the 2 to the 6th place value, which is here. Now we repeat the process with 19. We're looking for the highest power of 2 that divides at least once into 19. Notice 2 to the 5th is too large, which means we'll have a 0 in the 2 to the 5th place value. And then we go to 2 to the 4th, which is 16. 16 will divide into 19 at least once. So now we'll take 19 and divide by 16. Goes in one time. And now we have a remainder of 3. So the whole number 1 gives us the digit in the 2 to the 4th place value, which is here. And we repeat the process with 3. We're going to find the highest power of 2 that will divide at least once into 3. Well, 2 to the 3rd or 8 is too large, which means we'll have a 0 in the 2 to the 3rd place value, which is here. 2 to the 2nd or 4 is also too large, so we'll have another 0 in this place value, which brings us to 2 to the 1st or 2. So 3 divided by 2 is equal to 1. 1 times 2, of course, is 2. We subtract the remainder as 1. This 1 goes into the 2 to the 1st or the 2 place value, which is here. This remainder is less than the base, which gives us the digit in the 1's place value, which would be here. So what we found is 83 in base 10 is equal to 1010011 in base 2. Of course, if we want to check this, we can go in the reverse order, which I've already done to save some time. And so this one is in 2 to the 6th place value. This one here is in the 2 to the 4th place value. This one is in the 2 to the 1st place value. And finally, this one is in the 2 to the 0 or 1's place value. If we find the sum of these products, it does give us 83 in base 10. Let's take a look at one more example. We want to convert the base 10 number 2973 to base 6. So again, we first want to find the place values by starting with 6 to the 0, increasing the exponent by 1 to find several place values to the left, which we see here, 6 to the 1st, 6 to the 2nd, 6 to the 3rd, 6 to the 4th, and so on. I just noticed this should say we only use 0 through 5 for base 6, not base 2. And now we begin by determining the highest power of 6 that will divide at least once into 2973, which would be 6 to the 4th, because 6 to the 5th would be too large, which means our number in base 6 is going to have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 digits. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we begin by dividing 2,973 by 6 to the 4th, or 1,296. This divides in 2 times. 2 times our divisor is 2,592. And this difference, or the remainder, is 381. So the whole number of 2 gives us the digit in the 6 to the 4th place value, which is here. Now we repeat the process using the remainder of 381. We want to find the highest power of 6 that will divide at least once into 381. And notice how 216 would divide at least once into 381. So now we'll divide by 216 to find our next digit. 216 goes once into 381. We subtract. The remainder is 165. So 1 is our next digit. Now we repeat again. We're going to determine the highest power of 6 that would divide into 165 at least once. And notice how 6 to the second, or 36, will divide at least once into 165. So we take 165 and divide by 36. 36 goes into 165 4 times. 4 times 36 is 144, the remainder of 21. So our next digit is 4, which will be in the 6 to the second place value, or here. Repeat using 21. 6 divides at least once into 21, so we'll take 21 and divide by 6. 6 divides into 21 3 times. 6 times 3 is 18. We subtract. Notice here our remainder is 3, less than our base of 6, so we're actually done. The next digit would be this 3, the whole number of our quotient. And the last digit in the ones place value is our remainder that's less than the base of 3. So we found that 2,973 base 10 is equal to 21433 in base 6. And again, to verify this, we can go in the opposite direction. We can take our number in base 6 and write out each place value. So this 2 represents 2 times 6 to the 4th. This 1 represents 1 times 6 to the 3rd. This 4 represents 4 times 6 to the 2nd. This 3 represents 3 times 6 to the 1st. And finally, this 3 represents 3 times 6 to the 0. Simplifying, we can verify this is equal to 2,973 in base 10. I hope you found this helpful.